ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமஹா. திஸ் இஸ் சாந்தினி ஃப்ரம் பொன் வித்யாஸ்ரம் ஸ்கூல். ஐ வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் டு த செஷன். திஸ் செஷன் இஸ் த கண்டினியூஷன் ஆஃப் ஃபைபர் டு ஃபேப்ரிக். இன் த ப்ரீவியஸ் செஷன் வி ஹாவ் டிஸ்கஸ்ட் அபவுட் த ஹிஸ்ட்ரி ஆஃப் கிளாத்திங், வெரைட்டி இன் ஃபைபர்ஸ் அண்ட் த டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் நேச்சுரல் அண்ட் சிந்தட்டிக் ஃபைபர்ஸ். I hope the previous session helped you to understand the terms fiber, yarn and fabrics. Students, our last session ended with a question. Do you remember? Let's have a look into it and then we will get into the topic. Synthetic fibers are not used during hot and humid weather. Why? You know, wearing synthetic cloths are not advisable during hot and humid weather because synthetic fibers do not absorb sweat and it stick to the body. They are non-porous, so it does not allow proper air circulation and irritate the skin. Let us have a recap of cotton. Cotton is a bushy plant of 5 to 6 feet height with broad 3 leaves. It is grown in the fields. Cotton plants are usually grown at places having black soil and alluvial soil with warm climate and moderate rainfall. The fruits of the cotton plants are about the size of a lemon. Once the fruits are matured, the balls burst open and the seeds covered with cotton fibers can be seen. Once the fruits are matured, the cotton balls are picked by hand. This process is called hand picking. What is hand picking? The process of picking the fruits by hand. Now we have the cotton balls. From here, the story of making cotton yarn from cotton fiber begins. We know that we obtain cotton fibers from fruit of cotton plant. So we have to separate the seeds from the cotton fiber, which are present in the cotton balls. This process is called ginning. Ginning is the process of removing cotton seeds from the cotton fiber. It is done by passing harvested cotton through a machine called roller gins. Ginning was traditionally done by combing manually and also done by hand. The fibrous material left after separating cotton seed is called lint. Lint is nothing but cotton fiber. Once fibers are obtained, they are converted into yarns. By the process of spinning, fibers are converted into yarns. What is spinning? The process of making yarn from fiber is called spinning. The lint is directly spun into yarn on spinning wheels. Let us learn to make yarn. For this, pinch some cotton between your thumb and index finger and pull. Simultaneously, twist the pulled fibers between your fingers to get thicker and stronger thread. That is yarn. The process of making yarn from fibers is called spinning. Spinning can be done by hand or by using a spindle or a charka. For large scale production of yarn, spinning machines were used. I hope now you know how to make yarn, right? After fiber has been spun into yarn, it is sent to mills to be made into cloth. Weaving and knitting are the two methods of making yarn into fabric. Weaving is the arrangement of two sets of yarn to make fabric. What is weaving? The process of making fabric using two sets of yarn. During weaving, initially one set of yarn is fitted on a loom. The other set of yarn is interlaced with right angle with first set of yarn so as to get fabric. Cloth is woven by weavers on a machine called loom. The looms may be operated by hand or called hand looms, or by electricity called power looms. You know, India has a rich heritage in producing traditional handloom cloth. Fabric is also done by the process of knitting. Have you seen someone making a woolen sweater? It is done by interlocking loops of woolen yarn. This method is called knitting. Weaving needs a set of two or more yarns. However, knitting can be done by a single yarn or a group of yarns. Knitting needles are used to make fabrics by hand on a small scale. In factories, knitting is done using machines. Besides sweaters, other garments such as t-shirts, gloves, caps, and even dolls can also be made by knitting. When compared with woven fabrics, knitted fabrics are more stretchable. Let us read the steps involved in getting fabric from cotton balls to understand the process in an easy way. The matured cotton balls are hand-picked and cotton seeds are separated from the fibers by the process of ginning. The fibrous material left after separating cotton seed is called lint. Lint is nothing but fiber. The fiber obtained is spun into yarn by the process of spinning. And the yarn is converted into fabric by the process of weaving and knitting. Let me share you an interesting fact. As a part of independence, Mahatma Gandhi gave new strength to the art of spinning yarn on the charkha to promote Swadeshi. He encouraged Indians to wear cloths made of khadi instead of imported British-made cloths. Characteristics of cotton fabric. Cloths made from cotton are soft, light, and durable. They absorb moisture easily and allow our skin to breathe. These qualities make cotton cloths most suitable to wear in hot summers. A variety of cloths such as khadi and denim are made from cotton. Denim is used to make jeans. Cotton is used to manufacture cotton textiles and papers. It is also used as fillers in pillows, quilts, and mattresses. It is used for making surgical bandages, bed sheets, and table cloths. We also obtain natural fiber from jute. It is also called as golden fiber because of its color, which ranges from off-white to brown. It is one of the cheapest fibers. It is obtained from the stems of the jute plant. Jute grows best in alluvial soil with standing water and a humid climate with plenty of rainfall. The crop is planted during March to May and is harvested when it is in the flowering stage. The harvested stalks of the plant are soaked in water for a few days until they start rotting. This process is called retting. What is retting? The process of obtaining fiber from the stems of the plant by keeping them in stagnant water for a few days. This process makes the separation of fiber easier. The fibers are then separated from the rotting stem and it is dried. The fibers are made into yarn by twisting the strands together. This process of making yarn from fiber is called? Yes, spinning. You know, jute cloth is biodegradable, making it an eco-friendly fabric. It is strong and durable. Jute is used for making cloths, shopping bags, carpets, curtains, ropes, and mats. It is also used to make sacks for storing grains. This helps in sustaining the livelihoods of millions of small farmers. It is also used for making wall hangings for decoration. We also yield plant fiber from coir. Coir is a rough fiber obtained from the outer covering of coconuts. It is relatively waterproof and resistant to damage by seawater. It is used to make products such as mats, ropes, brushes and packing material. Kerala in India and Sri Lanka are the major producers of coir. It is also used for making carpets, bags, mattresses and pillows. Hemp fiber is obtained from the hemp plant. Hemp is the strongest natural fiber in the world. It's known to have over 5,000 different uses. It grows well in loamy soil. It is tough and used to make ropes, carpets, socks, bags, cloths and paper. You know, a special kind of plastic is also made from hemp fiber. Flax fiber is obtained from the stem of flax plant. It is one of the first fibers to be used in the textile industry. The fiber made from flax plant is called linen. It is used to make not only linen cloths but also high quality paper for printing currency. And also it is used for making ropes. We get silk cotton fiber from the fruit of the kapok tree. It is commonly used as a filling inside pillows, sleeping bags and for making cloths. Water absorption properties of fibers. The absorption of water by fabrics is an important factor that determines how comfortable a fabric is to wear. Different fibers have different water absorption capacities. Fabrics that absorb very small amount of water are very uncomfortable to wear in hot and humid environments. The fabrics that absorb a large amount of water are quite comfortable to wear. Natural fibers have higher water absorbing capacities than synthetic fibers. We know that cotton fibers are good absorbent and it is the best one to wear on summer season. Synthetic fibers are not a good absorbent and also it irritates the skin. Let us learn some additional information. India is the largest producer of jute and its products in the world. Almost 85-90% of the world's jute is cultivated in the Sundarbans dells in West Bengal, India and Bangladesh. Cotton fibers used in mattresses have natural resistance to fungus and mites. Hemp fiber has antibacterial properties and linen is the most hygienic textile for hospital beds. A silkworm spins a continuous thread of silk of about 800 meters for making the cocoon. Let us recall the lesson. We wear clothes to protect ourselves against weather and insects and to look good. Before clothes were invented, people covered their body with leaves and skins of animals. Clothes are made from different types of fabrics. Fibers are thin strands that are twisted together to make threads or yarn. Yarn are threads or woven or knitted to make fabrics. Fabrics are then cut and stitched to make cloths. Weaving is done on looms. Fibers can be natural or synthetic. Natural fibers are obtained from plants and animals. For example, cotton, jute and silk. Artificial fibers are made from chemical substances. For example, nylon, rayon and polyester. Ginning, spinning, weaving and knitting are the processes used in making cotton fabrics. Cotton fibers are obtained from cotton balls. Jute, flax and hemp fibers are obtained from the stem of the plants. Silk cotton fibers are obtained from the dried fruit of the kapok tree. Coir is obtained from the outer covering of coconuts. Let us find answer for these questions. Complete the following with the name of plant parts from where fibers are obtained. Flax are obtained from which part of the plant? Yes, stem. Cotton is obtained from which part of the plant? Fruit. Jute is obtained from which part of the plant? Yes, stem. Coir is obtained from which part of the plant? Outer covering of coconut. Hemp is obtained from which part of the plant? Yes, stem. Linen is obtained from which part of the plant? Stem. Can we answer a few more questions? Yes. Spinning is a process of making dash from dash, yarn from fiber. Spinning is a process of making yarn from fiber. Dash and dash are natural fibers obtained from plants. Cotton and jute are natural fibers obtained from plants. Keeping the jute plant in water for a few days is called dash, retting. Keeping the jute plant in water for a few days is called retting. Ginning is done to separate dash from dash, cotton seeds from fibers. Dash and dash are used for making fabrics. Weaving and knitting are used for making fabrics. Differentiate between cloth and cloths. Cloth is a piece of fabric which is used to make clothes. Cloth is nothing but fabric. Clothes are nothing but stitched dresses. Clothes are made of cloth. Let us complete the journey of a cotton plant to fabric by using words given below. A cotton plant is a bushy plant which grows well in black soil and alluvial soil. The cotton plant bears a large number of small green pods called cotton balls. When these balls, they burst, exposing the white fibers of cotton. This cotton is sent to a factory where machines are used to clean them. The cleaned cotton is combed and twisted into yarn. A loom weaves the two sets of yarn together and make fabric. Let us solve the crossword puzzle. A fabric made from flax fiber. Linen. It is the process of making fabrics from yarn. Yes, weaving. It is a weaving machine. Loom. It is the cheapest natural fiber. Yes, jute. It is cotton fiber. Lint. It is a synthetic fiber. Yes, nylon. I hope this session helped you to understand the lesson better. Students, you have to solve this crossword puzzle. We should always wear clean and sun-dried clothes. We should look after our clothes well. Wearing dirty or damp clothes can also cause skin diseases. Thank you.